a cold but sunny day here at Forest Glen Park on Mike Frame Field. We have a Crossroads League matchup, game one of four here in this series as the Bethel Pilots take on the Huntington Foresters. Good afternoon, everybody. Welcome inside Forest Glen Park. Carson Watkins with you, taking you through the action today as we get ready, as I said before, the first of a four-game series. Foresters coming into today 12-11, 7-5 in the Crossroads League, coming off of a split last weekend versus the Mount Vernon Nazarene Cougars, a close loss in game one, 4-3, and then a 6-3 win before a 15-4 win on Saturday, and then another loss, 12-3. To end the series, they're sitting at fourth in the Crossroads League. For the Pilots, 8-14 so far on the season, 3-9 thus far in the Crossroads. They are also coming off of a split against St. Francis, as this one can shake up standings, especially with the Foresters having a big series against the Taylor Trojans here next week. Tyler Papenbrock getting the ball today for the Foresters. Papenbrock, the 3.72 ERA, 2-1 on the season with three, not a big strikeout guy, does get good soft contact, and that's what he'll look to do today. Cooper Tolson leading us off today, a 260 hitter on the season, 398 on base guy, and Papenbrock's first offering is going to be hit right back to him. Papenbrock gets an easy one pitch, one out, as he gets Tolson to ground out to the pitcher. Just like that, one pitch, one out for Papenbrock. Now stepping up to the plate, Jordan Lancorn, 320 hitter on the season, as he takes a look at ball one. Papenbrock down in the hole quickly, 2-0 thus far. Here's a 2-0 from Papenbrock. It is going to be checked down, and that'll be Papenbrock's first strike of the afternoon. Papenbrock leading the staff so far this season, as I just said, makes soft contact. He saw that on his first pitch. That one low and inside, going for the appeal. Does not go that time. 3-1 for Papenbrock. Lancorn, a contact guy as well. He does slug 574, checks the swing again, did not go, and that'll be a walk for Lancorn. His seventh walk of the season. Now digging in will be Jacob Sitterly. Sitterly, 284 hitter on the season. Papenbrock checking the runners, first base runner of the day, and he gets Sitterly to take a big rip at strike one. That one goes low for a ball for Papenbrock. A 1-1 count is going to be fouled back. In the hole now is Sitterly, hitting in the three hole today. Sitterly, one to work counts. He has 11 walks on the season, but has been hit by a pitch six times. Papenbrock's pickoff goes wide. tries to get it over. Malott couldn't get it there, and that'll be a advance.
Let's try this.
For Landcorn. And now runner in scoring position with the 1-2 is Papenbrock's pickoff attempt went into the turf. Papenbrock wanting to keep out of the hole early, but goes wild with it. Throw down to third will not be there. And just like that, Landcorn makes his way around the base path as Wheeler couldn't get there in time. The throw, it went way over Wheeler's head. Now a 2-2 for Papenbrock with a runner on third, trying to keep his team out of the hole here in the first inning. Papenbrock gets a foul off from Siderly. Siderly, the starting first baseman today, and something's going on. His umpire is checking his bat, and all of a sudden, Siderly is going back to the dugout. His coach is getting a talking to. Not sure if he's using an illegal bat. Must be the case. He goes and picks up another one. Umpire taking the bat back, and interesting development. Siderly has to go get another bat to finish off this AB. So a 2-2 count. Now Papenbrock gets a swing and a miss from Siderly for two outs. Papenbrock's fourth strikeout of the season. And now two outs, runner on third. Dominic Diesler steps in, 361 hitter, has 12 RBIs for the season and could use a huge 13th here to get the Pilots up early. Papenbrock's first offering is in there for a strike. Landcorn sitting there at third, hoping to get in. Wheeler's framing attempt does not go as planned, as it's a 1-1 now for Diesler. Diesler down the first base line, but foul, gets into a 1-2 count. And now here's the 1-2 from Papenbrock, and it is in there. Foresters thought they were going to the bench. No such luck. That's Diesler. Takes a look at ball two, and now the count runs full for Papenbrock. There's a one pitch, one out first batter for Papenbrock, and now has to deal with Diesler with Stout on deck. Full count here for Papenbrock is fouled off again. We'll do this once more. Want to keep that pitch count low. I'm curious to see what Coach Frame is thinking in the dugout right now. In case you have not heard, the game first tomorrow have been postponed and moved to Monday, so that might impact his bullpen as Diesler will take his base. Second walk of the inning for Papenbrock, his fifth of the season. And they'll bring in a courtesy runner for the catcher, Diesler. And now see if they try to execute the double steal. First offering is going to go outside. Here's a 1-0. Papenbrock goes high. And Papenbrock finds himself in the hole early. As he's desperately trying to keep the bases. That one's outside, and just like that, an 0-3 count. We'll see what they decide to do here. Stout, a 282 hitter, has one long ball and a triple. Could clear the bases. If he decides to swing at it, he'll take the fastball. An easy decision there for Wheeler as they try to execute the double steal. No such luck. As now two runners in scoring position, a 3-1 count. Pembrock needs to battle back in this count. The 3-1 swung on towards center. Paulina goes back on it and makes the catch. Paulina gets Papenbrock out of the first inning, and we will go to the second. Bottom of the first. Papenbrock leaves runners on second, third.
That we can switch between, but it's not being made.
Okay.
Which is for the best. There used to be a platform out there, and they think people work in, sometimes they're like, hey, you can't move. Like, it moves, and I'm like, looking, and
the whole camera would move. On YouTube.
Alright. Whenever you have a second, can you turn me up?
Welcome back. The ace of the Pilots, Frank Plezac, getting the ball, a 3.53 ERA with a 1.15 whip and heavy strikeout numbers, 55 on the season, over 13 strikeouts per nine innings, went eight innings his last start with eight strikeouts in a 4-3 victory and gave up a long ball. He'll deal with Bryce Deckman hitting 290 in the leadoff spot today for the Foresters. Two more pitches for Plezac, leaving a legacy here at Bethel. If you are familiar, his brother is also a major league pitcher, a free agent at the moment, former Cleveland Guardian. Goes down and now digging in the right fielder, Deckman. Batting 290 on the season with a 433 on base percentage. Can get a little power in that bat as well with two long ones. Foresters needing wins, and that one goes low, keeping up with the top four in the Crossroads League. Here's the 1-0. Swung on. Deckman goes up the middle. And a leadoff single for Bryce Deckman. Right over the head of Plezac. Gets the Foresters cooking to start off for Baroa. Batting 261, a speedster on the base pass as well, has 10 stolen bases so far on the season, would like to move Deckman over as well. Deckman, huge leadoff, swung on by Baroa for the first strike for Plezac of the afternoon. 3-2 record so far for Plezac this season. They give him the green light as Deckman has to get back in a hurry on that sly pickoff move. Mm-hmm. as I said before, just a very impressive whip. Deckman goes, fly ball into center. Camping under is Tolson. Tolson makes the catch, and it's up to Deckman to beat it back to first, and he does, but a fly out for Baroa will lead to Matt Wolf into the batter's box. Wolf in his third year with the Foresters, the former midshipman. Matt Wolf manning third base today. Also has designated hit it in the past, but is taking the hot corner now. See if Deckman decides to go again. Plesak watching him with a close full eye as Wolf fouls off his first. Wolf batting 324 on the season with 16 RBIs. Here's the 0-1. It's fouled back again. And Wolf in the hole quickly going down 0-2 to Plesak. Here's the 0-2 to Wolf. Deckman goes low. Throw down to second. It actually hits off of Deckman. He does get the stolen base. Make sure he's all right. Not even sure where that clipped him. They give him time. Deckman shaking it off the low, but does get his base. One, two to Wolf is swung on and another foul ball. See if Deckman wants to move to third as well. Has an opportunity with Wolf right there in that batter's box. An opportunity to make the catcher think about it. This one goes to Stahl at short. Deckman will advance. Wolf will be thrown out at first. So Bryce Deckman moves to third. Wolf grounds out. Does advance the runner, and now it's going to be the second year. Jordan Mellott batting 281 on the season with 19 RBIs. Mellott takes the first pitch inside for a ball. Mellott fouls off. Mellott likes to crowd that plate. A power hitter slugging over 500 on the season with a 321 on base percentage. 1-1 to Mellott is swung on, high fly ball. Camping under it is Dolan, and he'll make the grab. And once again, a runner left stranded as we will go to the top of the second, still knotted up at zero.
Two waters.
You're
both games?
Yeah.
Welcome back. Dolan makes the final out of the first and will step into the batter's box. Takes a big rip at strike one. Dolan, a 333 hitter so far this season, has taken six walks but finds himself in the hole early. 0-2. Pappenbrock's 0-2 is going to be fouled off. Dolan stays alive. It looks like it ricocheted off of Wheeler's mask. We'll do the 0-2 again, and a late swing from Dolan fouls it off towards his dugout. Greensled had to get out of the way of that one. The 0-2 once more is going up towards Kirstenak, fires it over, and once again, the leadoff batter is retired. Greenslade stepping in as a designated hitter today. 286 batting average on the season. Takes the first pitch outside for a ball. This one goes low. Pappenbrock still settling in. As I said, a little over a month left in the season. Every game matters. Here's the 2-0 swung on towards Wolf at third. Wolf gloves it, cross diamond, he gets him out. Two batters, two outs. And now that'll lead, trying to keep this inning alive, will be Elijah Gaines, a 196 hitter on the season. Does get on base about 27% of the time. Pappenbrock would like a 1-2-3 inning here and a good start as he gets a swing and a miss for strike one. Pappenbrock's low pitch evens the count 1-1. Low again, 2-1 the count. Swing on, another swing and a miss for Pappenbrock. Having good stuff so far today. The 2-2 is just a little high, and a full count for Gaines. The 3-2 is swung on and missed. Another strikeout for Pappenbrock. It's second of the day. Good morning, good afternoon, and good night. Cam Clarkson will dig into the bottom of the second. Welcome back. Bottom of the second, still knotted up. 0-0 as Cam Clarkson checks in. Two long ones, had one dead center against Manchester last time we saw the Foresters at Forest Glen Park. 391 batter on the season, designated hitting today. Takes his first pitch outside for a ball. Here's a 1-0. It's going to go low for a ball. Clips the corner for the first strike to Clarkson. Clarkson slugs 696 on the season. Some power right here. Cam Clarkson up the middle. And another leadoff base hit for the Foresters as Cam Clarkson rips it right past Plezak. And now Paulina will step into the box. 253 hitter on the season with 7 RBIs and a long one. Paco Paulina digs in on Plezak. Deckman was able to get to third, but could not. Score as Paulina fouls off his first, off his foot. Here's the 0-1 to Paulina, swung on towards the hot corner, and it gets through. Clarkson will be held up at second, and the Foresters have runners on first and second after back-to-back base hits on Plezak. Ryan Wheeler now steps in. 343 hitter on the season with a 521 on base percentage, slugs over 600. And Wheeler takes the first strike right down the pipe. Wheeler's going to lay down the bunt over to Plezak. Advances the runners. It's a good bunt. Wheeler can't beat it out, but does advance both runners. For the sacrifice. Sam Kurstenak now the shortstop. Only one RBI so far this season, but a golden opportunity here for the 286 hitter. Swings and fouls back, strike one into the trees. A little 3D action for you here behind the press box. The 0-1 to Kurstenak is going to be a strike, and he finds himself in the hole early. Cade Flores on deck in the 9 hole. The 0-2 swung on, a little bouncer back to Plezak. Clarkson going to try to beat it off the plate. The catcher drops the ball. Diesler dropped the ball. He was in front of the plate. Nonetheless, that's an RBI. As Clarkson comes home and Paulina goes to third, as he made the right play. It was kind of an awkward throw, however. Now runners on the corner for the Foresters. Catcher Diesler couldn't hold on. Got laid on the bunt. That one goes flying into the stands. Coach Fram electing to have Flores lay down a bunt. The 1-0 swung on towards left field. Coming in on it, Coleman. Paulino waits to go. It falls right fair, and he comes home, and Flores. A flyout that looked like Coleman was going to grab it, but just couldn't reach there. And just like that, the Foresters are up 2-0 with runners on first and second, one out. And they'll go to the top of the order with Deckman. The ninth RBI on the season for Flores. And back to the top of the order for the Foresters. Deckman got a single his last time up. And looks at ball one outside. Flores has 3 stolen bases on the season. Kirstenak. Also a speedster over there at short. Here's the 1-0. Deckman towards center. Tolson comes in on it, and it drops. Here comes Kirstenak around third. The play at the plate will not be there. The Foresters are up 3. Kirstenak all the way. From second to third, Deckman grabs an RBI. His 5th of the season, and now digging in is Baroa. Baroa flying out to center his last at bat, but the Foresters a 3-run bottom of the second on Plezak. First offering to Baroa goes high. Here's the 1-0 to Baroa, goes low. The 2-0 swung on towards center again. Tolson makes the grab. Advancing is Flores. And now runners on the corners has another flyout for Baroa to center. And that'll step in Matt Wolf. Grounded out to short his last at bat. Wolf, big rip at strike one. The 0-1 swung on, fouled back into the stands, And Wolf finds himself in the hole early. The 0-2 swung on and missed, and that'll be an end to a 3-1 bottom of the second for the Foresters. And now stepping in Coleman for the Pilots, and the top of the order for Bethel. Welcome back, Tayshawn Coleman digging in for his first at bat of the day here in the bottom of the third. Papenbrock getting some run support as Wolf comes in on this one, tries to barehand it and can't do it. See if they credit Wolf with an error. Don't believe so, tough play. But a one pitch. First time today that Papenbrock was unable to retire the leadoff hitter. And now back to the top of the order we go. As Tolson digs in, he grounded out to Papenbrock, and this is going to be a butt. Tolson down the line, and he will get thrown out once again by Papenbrock. But does advance Coleman. High for ball one. Coleman dancing a little bit on second. Pilots down three, looking to make up some ground here in the top of the third. Papenbrock on the mound and gets a big rip from Jordan Lancorn. Walked his first appearance. Flips the corner for a strike. Lancorn wanted to check that with the umpire, make sure he knows that's the zone. Here's the 1-2 from Papenbrock. Delivers, swung on and miss. Another strikeout for Papenbrock. His second out, and now it's going to be up. Check up Sitterly, who struck out his first appearance at the plate. Here's the 0-1, a little high. Sitterly has 24 runs batted in. here in the cleanup spot. Here's the 1-1 once more, and it'll be outside for a ball, 2-1 the count. The 2-1 is going to be a strike at the knees looking, and a 2-2 for Papenbrock with two outs here in the top of the third. Papenbrock's 2-3 is going to be high and outside. Coleman goes, steals the base. Now runner on third, full count with two outs for Papenbrock. Is got him looking. Thought he walked, not the case, and Papenbrock with two strikeouts after getting a leadoff single, and the Foresters will go to the bottom of the third. Welcome back. A third, a three-run spot in the bottom of the second. Jordan Watt lead off, the only batter who didn't get an opportunity in the second, but he'll dig in for the third. Three-run cushion for the Foresters in a big Crossroads League game. Plezak has been tough to hit against, and the Foresters looking to protect this lead. A nine-inning game here in game one. The 1-0 is swung on. As Malott went around. The 1-1 is going to be low for a ball. The 2-1 is going to be low and outside. Here's a 3-1 to Malott, and it's low on outside, and a leadoff walk for Jordan Malott. Now Clarkson will dig in. He singled his last at-bat just an inning ago. Outside for a ball. 1-0 swung on. Backing up is Tolson. It's back, and Tolson grabs it. Malott has to scatter back to first base right at the wall. Clarkson wished that fence was moved in just a little bit. No such luck. About as deep as you can get in this park without getting a home run. You talk about batting average expected on balls in play. Popular statistic, and like I said, Clarkson probably wishes that that was probably a pretty high expected batting average. That leads Polina into the box. He's 1-for-1 on the day with a single. Electing to lay down the bunt right down the third base line. Coming in on a Landcorth. He's going to try to let it go foul, and he does. That's a tough break. Really can't get much of a better bunt than that. Just didn't get a good roll on it. Landcorth just knew that he was not going to get. Paco Paulina, so we just decided to let the ball go foul. So now it's 0-1 to Paco Paulina. Right back towards Plezak. Grabbing it is Gaines. Flips it over. And a double play. Promising start to the inning off for the Malott walk ends in a quick inning for the Foresters, and they lead by 3 as we go to the top of the fourth. Welcome back. 2 strikeouts last inning for Papenbrock. Leads to Diesler, the catcher stepping back in. Takes a first pitch strike as Papenbrock spikes that one to Wheeler. The 1-1 is going to go inside for a ball. 2-1 the count. It goes high, 3-1 the count now for Papenbrock. Papenbrock with a good outing so far. A couple strikeouts, has managed the base pass well, but does get the strike there. I thought that might have been a leadoff walk. And it will be a leadoff walk regardless as he gets the count full. Diesler will take his base and the courtesy runner will come on. Jesse Stout now digs in. Stout flew out to center his last at bat. and takes a first pitch strike right down the pipe. The 0-1 is going to go high, throw down to first to Malott. Forces all red to scurry back to the bag. Good heads up play there from Wheeler, however. Here's the 1-1, it's going to go far. All red scurries to second base. Swung on towards foul ground. It's going to go into the Pilots bullpen. 2-2 the count. Two is low. Once again, Papenbrock runs the count full. Runner goes, 3-2 is swung on a miss, throw down to third is going to be late. Try to get the strike him out, throw him out, not the case. All red does advance and a strikeout for Stout. Now stepping in is Dolan, he led off the second and grounded out to short. Good grab there from Wheeler on that outside pitch. There's a 1-0, swung on and missed. A big rip at it. Dolan has 4 RBIs on the season. Only 1 out with a runner on third for Papenbrock. That one foul back. Here's a 1-2, it's gonna go just missed the foot of Dolan, 2-2 the count. Papenbrock catches Wheeler looking. My apologies, that was Dolan. Wrong scorecard. That's going to be Corbin Greenslide now steps in. Grounded out to Matt Wolf over at third, his last at bat. Now 2 outs. Papenbrock has to work with a runner on third to keep his scoreless game going here in the top of the fourth. The 0-1 is going to be in there, and Papenbrock gets ahead quickly. The 0-2 is swung on and missed. Papenbrock with a huge scream as he struts off the mound, striking out 3 in a row. We'll go to the bottom of the fourth here on FDN Sports. Welcome back. Wheeler behind the plate is going to dig in for the bottom of the fourth. Forrester still lead by three. Carson Watkins joining you. Wheeler laid down a sacrifice bunt his last time. It led to the big scoring run for the Foresters in the bottom of the second as Wheeler takes the first pitch strike. Wheeler skies this one towards Dolan in the gap, but it does drop. A little bit of miscommunication there in the outfield. Leads to a, as Dolan and Tolson couldn't figure out whose ball it was, it will result in a base hit for Wheeler. Parker Richards comes in for Wheeler as his courtesy runner. Richards just beats the pickoff attempt back to the bag. Kirshenak digging in, got an RBI single his last at bat. Richard, big lead. Kirshenak takes a big rip at it. For a strike. Yeah, one. Richards goes back again. Getting real comfortable leading off over there. Richards goes. Throw down to second. Will not be there. Bethel in disbelief. I thought that was rather close. Nonetheless, it will be a runner on second as Richards gets a stolen base. Kirshenak in the hole, however, 0-2. Low and outside for a ball. Plesac offering is swung on down the third base line and fouled. Let's do it again. One, two, swung on. Over to Gaines at second. Beats out Kirshenak, but does get Richards. Over to third. Flores stepping in. He singled and got an RBI in his last at bat. Had an opportunity for another RBI. With one out and a runner on third. Richards dancing over there at third, ripped here towards right field. Dolan going back on it, makes the grab. Here comes Richards speeding towards the plate. He'll get there standing up, and a sacrifice fly leads to the second RBI of the day for Flores. And now going back to the top of the order, Bryce Deckman. Two singles on the day for Deckman. Familiar spot for him in the leadoff position. As the base is cleared. Two outs, Deckman fly ball towards left, and it is tailing foul. It's going to go in the creek. We're not getting that baseball back. It's too wet. Thanks to my amazing crew to my right here, putting on a good broadcast for you today. Just Deckman skies this one to Dolan and right. They'll take it. Flores, the sacrifice fly. Richards scurried around the bases. The Foresters get their fourth, and we'll go to the top of the fifth. Foresters lead by four. Elijah Gaines gonna step in, leading off near the bottom of the order. Struck out his last at bat. Takes the first pitch for a ball. Three strikeouts for Papenbrock last inning. Gets a strike on pitch number two. Here's the 1-1. It'll be in there for a strike. Two on the count now. The 2-1 from Papenbrock. Make that four straight strikeouts for Tyler Papenbrock. Six hits so far today for the Foresters, only one for the Pilots. Four straight strikeouts for Papenbrock as Coleman digs in, hit a leadoff single last time at the plate. The 1-0 swung on him, big miss. The 1-1 swung on, fouled back. Papenbrock making quick work right now of the Pilots. Here's the 1-2. It's going to go low for a ball. The 2-2. Swung on and missed. To complete the strikeout, down to Malat, and make that five in a row for Papenbrock. Tolson takes the first pitch for a ball. 0-2 on the day. Sacrifice bunted his last time up. This one towards the corner. This goes past Wolf and stays fair. Tolson rounding for second. Coming in on it is Barraro. And they'll bring it in for a two-out double. The first double given up by Papenbrock today. That one was ripped past Wolf. Thank you. That one goes. Wheeler gets it back. Throw down to Wolf at third is just a little late. Stolen base for Tolson. Now once again, Papenbrock has a runner on third. Here's the 1-0, is swung on and missed. Lincoln in the box, walked his first at bat. Here's a 2-1, gonna go high. And Papenbrock in the hole, 3-1 now. Here's a 3-1, and it'll go outside, and that's a walk, second walk of the day for Lincoln. Now runners on the corner, and here comes pitching coach Mike Malacca. Talking to Papenbrock, want to keep this lead where it's at. A little bit of strategy. To the meeting with Coach Malacca. It's going to be Jacob Sitterly coming in. Foresters have had a couple games get away from them this season. Here's the 1-0. Swung on and missed. Wheeler checking out both bases. Here's a 1-1. It's going to go in there for a looking strike. Just like that, it's going to be Sitterly in the hole. Sitterly has 3 home runs on the season. Could crack this game wide open with one swing. This one ripped to Wolf at third. Going to have to beat it out. Can't do it. Papenbrock avoids the runner on third again and keeps his shutout alive. To the bottom of the fifth we go on FDN Sports. Welcome back in. Please, Zach, going. Please, Zach, going back to the mound. He's given up 6 hits so far today. He has tendency to go deep into games. Nobody warming up in either bullpen, letting both pitchers have their game. And we'll get ready to go. Once again, as Baroa steps in. Two flyouts to center field thus far today. This is his third time to the order, Baroa. This one back, Coleman lost track of it. It's over Coleman's head and it bounces. It's a ground rule double. Leadoff ground rule double for Baroa. How about that? Coleman lost it in the clouds. A little bit gray out there today. Got turned around on it. And leads to a runner on second for Wolf. Now Wolf digs in, runner goes. This one hit back to Plezak. Wolf can't beat it out, but nonetheless, Baroa trying to get an early steal. Wolf grounds out, 0-for-3 on the day now. And now Jordan Mellott will dig in with a 0-for-1 on the day with a walk and a fly out. Mellott takes a look at strike one. Please, again, his third time through the order. We'll see, like I said, what kind of leash they're going to give him. With 8 innings, his last start. Perhaps the extra day, 2 days of rest on Saturday and Sunday will allow for a deeper bullpen today. Once again, a reminder, tomorrow's game has been postponed till Monday at 3. It's going to be a little bit of a nicer day, a wintry mix expected tomorrow. But back here, Mellott takes a look at strike two down the pipe. Here's the 1-2. It's going to be fouled back. Swung on. This one goes towards right. Dolan comes in on it, makes the sliding grab. Here comes Baroa in, and the throw will be late. The sacrifice fly, and the Foresters have a 5-run lead. Clarkson now stepping in with the bases cleared. 2 outs and a 5-run Forester lead. Clarkson singled his first at bat and then a deep fly out to center his second at bat. And he swings at the first pitch and fouls it into the Forester dugout. Here's the 0-1 to Clarkson. He takes a look at a low fastball. The 1-1 is going to go low for a ball. The 2-1 swung on down the left field line and fouled. The 2-2 to Clarkson is going to take a late grip at it and foul it off to stay alive. Two long balls so far this season for Clarkson. Dive can get on base, a 471 on base percentage, but not here as he takes a big rip at strike three. And that'll send us to the top of the sixth. We're halfway home as Diesler will lead off for the Pilots.
The fourth to score one after the leadoff double by Gregory Barrow.
Welcome back, Pavin Brock. Pavin Brock, only two hits through five innings. Dominic Pavin Brock has thrown 90 pitches. We'll see how long they let him go. As Diesler takes a look at strike one. Pavin Brock working quickly, however. Nobody warming up in the Forrester pen. 1-1. Swat fouled back. Here's the 1-2 swung on. This one a bouncer. Malott has to come off the bag. Flip to Pavin Brock, who bare hands it. And a leadoff out. A rare 3-1. Now it's going to be Stout checking in. Stout 0-2 on the day with a fly out to center and a strikeout. This one ripped over the head of Pavin Brock. Caster not coming in. Fires them a lot and gets them out. What a play there from Caster. Caster Nick. A quick two outs for Pavin Brock. Dolan digs in now, 0-2 on the day as he takes a struck out his last at bat. Looking and then grounded out to shortstop, his first at bat. This one swung on towards center. Polina backs up and comes in on it. And a quick 1-2-3 for Pavin Brock. We'll go to the bottom of the six. The Foresters lead by five. Welcome back. Paulina now digs in. Grounded into a double play his last at bat. Lead off here, and now it's another inning for Plesac as he fires in a first pitch fastball low for a ball. Seven hits so far for the Foresters against Plesac as Paulina has to duck out of the way of that one. Quick 2-0 hole for here's a 2-0, swung on and fouled back. Here's the 2-1, and it'll be spiked into the turf. 3-1 the count on Paulina. Paulina, a 366 on base guy. Does bat 253, my apologies. 3-1 is going to go low, and a Paulina will take his base. Right now, Plesac at 69 pitches. That'll send Wheeler into the, got a bloop single his last at bat. Wheeler bets 343 on the season. He'll dig in. Lefty will dig in. They're going to double check Paulina at first. Runner goes. This one ripped through the gap. Paulina rounding second. Dolan's going to try to get him at third. They're going to decide to cut him off as runners on the corner now as Paulina had to avoid that scorcher. And Wheeler will be replaced once again by Richards. Still nobody warming up in the pilot's pen. Shows what the coaching staff, the faith the coaching staff has in Plesac as Kirsternick checks in with an RBI on the day, grounded out to second. His last at bat. Goes lay down the bunt, going to try to execute the double steal, and no use for it as it's going to be an easy bag for Richards. Obviously knew they were going to fake the throw there. Still nothing in the pilot's pen. One to Kirsternick is going to be clipped the corner for a strike. Here's the 0-2. It's going to be fouled back, and we'll do it again. Here's the 0-2. Swung on down the line, and watch out in the dugout. Now here's the 0-2, it's going to be swung on, it's going to be, yeah, it's a force out, it was a fly ball, a double play, a costly mistake there by Paulina, who started charging as Gaines caught it out of the air. So I'll let Cade Flores step into the box with two outs and Richards on second as he takes his first pitch low for a ball. Here's the 1-0. Richards goes. Throw down to third. Had to kind of skate around the bag. Got whipped around, but does get the stolen base. Flores with two RBIs already on the day. The 2-0 swung on. This one goes towards center. Tolson coming in on it, and it drops in front of him. Another RBI for Flores. Three of the six runs today has come off the bat of Flores. He will get the single as Richards this one goes back to the bag. As Flores just got back. Flores goes as Deckman fouls it off into the dugout. Hit the fencing. Deckman has an RBI, flew out to right his last at bat. Deckman went around 0-2 in the hole. The 0-2 is going to go high. Tried to get him to chase. Flores goes. This one's skied high. Gaines camping under it, and it'll be a relatively easy put out for him. But another RBI for Flores puts the Foresters up six as we go to the top of the seventh. Welcome back to Forest Glen Park on Mike Frame Field. It's a 6-0 lead for the Foresters. Gonna let Pavan Brock go back on the mound. Elevated pitch count. Big swing. As Greenslade leading off, he struck out his last at bat. 0-2 on the day after grounding out to third. The 1-1 is going to be swung on and fouled back. The 1-2 from Pappen Brock. In there! Got him looking! Papenbrock is dialed in today. Now Elijah Gaines steps up. He's also in trouble with Papenbrock with two strikeouts. Papenbrock gets him for a first pitch strike. That pitch is going to go low. Here's had to get a little bit of a change in the ball here. Looks like someone's standing on the mound now in the Forrester pen, but not throwing any warm-up pitches yet. The 1-1 swung on. Now Gaines in the hole to Papenbrock again. The 1-2 from Papenbrock is going to be fouled off, and that one goes sailing into the trail. This one goes and got him looking. The third strikeout from Papenbrock on Gaines. Now Coleman steps. Tayshaun Coleman also struck out his last at bat. Ten strikeout day for Papenbrock. Coleman fouls off his first. I think 11, my apologies, just miscounted. Oh, and two in the hole. That one goes high. 107th pitch for Papenbrock. This one goes in there. Papenbrock thought he was ready to stroll off the mound, but they're going to give him the ball. 2-2 the count. The 2-2 from Papenbrock is going to send Coleman out of the box. The full count, got him! 12 strikeouts for Tyler Papenbrock. He strikes out the side, and that might be the lasting image of this one for Tyler Papenbrock. Nonetheless, it's stretch time. Foresters up 6. Welcome back. Digging in is Baroa. He doubled his last at bat, leading off. He'll lead off again here in the bottom of the seventh with a six-run cushion as he rips this one down the third base line, and it's fair. Start the carousel all the way to the wall. Baroa will go into second, standing up, and kaboom goes the Forester dugout. Back-to-back doubles for Baroa. Still nobody warming up here in the pen for the Pilots. And now it's going to be Wolf stepping up. Wolf swung on and just fouled. Coleman has to go retrieve that one out of. Here's the 1-0 to Wolf, and swung on, fouled again. Here's the 0-2 to Matt Wolf. It's swung on and missed as Wolf strikes out for the second time today. Now Jordan Mellott will come in. He had a sacrifice fly to right field that got him an RBI on the afternoon. Runner goes, Mellott skies this one, Coleman comes over for it, and it's going to go out of play, hits the trees. Going to send Baroa back and check him. Deal one, and they're going to send him all the way back as Dietzler tried to catch Baroa napping. No such luck. Baroa does go this time as Mellott skies this one into the gap. Coleman comes in on it, makes the catch all the way back to second, but Baroa there in time. Nonetheless, Gaines does drop the ball. Two outs now for Cam Clarkson as he digs in. Clarkson digging in, struck out his last at bat. 1-for-3 on the day with a single. Plesak has to fake the throw back to second as he steps off the mound to avoid the balk call, avoid Baroa going to third as Clarkson takes a big rip at that one. Here's the 0-1, and that one's sky fouled. Yeah. one swung on down the first base line and fouled. Clarkson got a lot of that one. So it's 0-2 to Clarkson again. The 2 is going to be fouled off. Clarkson could beat this one out, and he does. Here comes Burrow and home, and he gets there. Heads up base running from Burrow. Gets the Foresters their seventh run of the day as he could not complete the strikeout. Heads up base running from Burrow to get all the way home. And a 7-0 lead for the Foresters. Now we got some action in the Pilots' pen. Two outs, runner on first now for Plezak as this one's bounced up the middle, and they're going to go the short way to grab Clarkson, but nonetheless, Cam Clarkson possibly getting a rare RBI strikeout. So we'll go to the top of the eighth here on FDN Sports. Welcome back. Jonathan Baker taking the ball here in the eighth, trying to put a stamp on this one for the Foresters. Inflated ERA over 9, but does have 6 strikeouts, and as he's trying to protect the 7-run Forester lead. First offering from Baker is going to be fouled back. Leading off Coop Tolson at the top of the order. This one swung on. Kersenek grabs it and just beats out Tolson.
Oh,
Lankron now checks in. Walked his last at bat, but does take a look at strike one. This one swung on. Deckman hasn't got much action today and kind of lost that one, but does back up and eventually makes the grab. Two quick outs for Jonathan Baker. Now it's Jacob Sitterly. Digging in, he grounded out to Matt Wolf at third, his last two strikeouts on the day for him. This one's going to go outside for ball one. Outside for ball two. Here's a 2-0. It's going to be in there for a strike for Baker. Here's a 2-1. It'll go high. 3-1 the count. Baker's 3-1 will go for a strike. Both fooled me and Sitterly. This one's going to be chopped. Kursenak again goes across the diamond. And good morning, good afternoon, good night, Jonathan Baker. 3-up, 3-down. Forrest will go to the bottom of the eighth, protecting their 7-run lead. Welcome back. New pitcher on the mound. It's going to be Lucas Norak in his sixth appearance, an inflated ERA of over 12. It's to try to control the damage for the Foresters. Try to put his team in a comeback position. Here's a first offering. This one's ripped down the first baseline, and it's fair. How about that to start off for Wheeler? What a day for Wheeler. It's going to get stuck in the going go over the fence, and a double for Wheeler. Should have put an, most likely puts an end to his day. That one just had a lot of power on it. Looks like we have a substitution now. We do owe an Emil, I believe, to come into bat for Kirsteneck. Emil, a 171 hitter, that 310 on base percentage, does have 7 RBIs on the season. As he takes ball 2 in the dirt. This one ripped to the first baseman's Sitterly. He'll get the easy force out. Stick with the same batting order. They move Richards over. Flores will keep his spot in the batting order. 3 RBIs already on the day. Looking for 4 here with a runner on third as he takes a first pitch strike. That one hits the turf. Here comes Richards. He'll scurry in easily. Richards crosses home plate again. Wheeler setting him up well for the speedster around the base pass. Forcers lead by 8. Goes high, 2-1 the count now. Got game 2 for you coming up after this as well. Like to stay tuned in. Thanks for joining us. This one goes low. 3-1 the count. Here's the 3-1. It's going to be clip the corner for a strike. Full count. Swing on and stays alive. This one goes high and a walk for Flores. Just been an on-base machine today. What a productive day for him. Go back to the top of the order here. Deckman getting another up at bat. Had a high fly pop up to second. Spikes the pickoff maneuver. Here's the 1-0 Deckman. It'll go low again. Forcers have scored in 4 straight innings. Full count here for Deckman. He will take the apologies 3-0 as his first strike. 3-1 is swung on, and now the count's full. Now it's a full count for Deckman, and he will take a walk. Deckman, a single, walk and two flyouts today. Now it's Baroa coming up to the plate. He has doubled his last two at-bats. Baroa takes that one outside for a ball. This one swung on towards the gap and tries to double up Flores, but can't do it. Good snag there from third baseman Lancroft. Two outs for Nowak. Now it's Matt Wolf stepping in. Two outs, runners on first and second for Wolf as he looks at the first pitch in the dirt. This one goes inside for another ball. Wolf, this one goes, they're going to take the short way, try to, Deckman almost beat it out. No luck, the Foresters grab another run, and three more outs, so this one's in the history book. We'll be right back for the top of the ninth here on FDN Sports. Three more outs for the Foresters. Desler, Stout, and Dolan going to be the ones to try to put this one away. The Foresters are going to try to put away. Desler grounded out to first, his last at bat. The Foresters looking to continue his dominant performance. Fly ball, Deckman charging on it, but it'll be out of play. 1-1 the count. Here's the 1-1. That one swung on towards left. If it's fair, it is not fair. It goes right into the picnic tables. Now 1-2 the count. 1-2 is in the dirt. Wheeler gets his body in front of it. Two is outside, full count. Now for Baker. Jonathan Baker's full count is going to be just outside in the leadoff walk for Dessler. Everybody warming up in the Forrester pen. This is Baker's game. Now Stout comes in. He grounded out to short in his last at bat. This one's going to go out of play. The 0-1, that one goes high. Wheeler checks the runner at first. 1-1 from Baker is grounded. Wolf can't get there. Just like that. Stout gets on base, and it's 2-1, no outs. For the Pilots.
Now batting for the Pilots, right fielder number 25, Thomas Dolan.
This one's towards center. It's going to drop. Coming in on it, Paulina tries to get the runner at home. Malott's there. No can do. The shutout is over. And just like that, that's a run as Pilots go second. As Dolan inserts that one to Paulina in center. And Baker still has 7 runs to work with here, but if you're the Foresters, you're definitely going to want to start getting some outs. To state the obvious, this one's going to be towards the line. Morrow comes in, it struggles with it. Here comes the runner from third, and they're not going to get there. It's a stand-up double. Just like that, it's 3-8, and the Foresters' lead is collapsing in as Greenslade. Baroa had trouble handling it in the corner. Now it's 3-8 with Gaines stepping into the box. Mound visit is, now a couple Foresters going towards the pen. As Greenslade pushes in RBIs 5 and 6 on the season for the designated hitter. Now Baker has a runner on second. Came in the eighth and got a 1-2-3 as Gaines takes a look at strike one. Is the 0-1 in the turf. Baker's 1-1 is going to go in there for a strike. Think about one swing of the bat. This is just a three-run game. Gaines, yet to hit a long ball this year, has 9 RBIs, takes a big rip and a huge strikeout for Baker. That is one out for Coleman stepping in. First strikeout of the day for Baker. Coleman swinging at the first pitch and fouls it out. Coleman has struck out back-to-back. Here's the 0-1, swung on, tipped into the glove, and now Baker looking for a huge second strikeout. Here's the 0-2. It's going to be swung on over the head of Flores. Coming around is Green Sled into second. Coleman gets there sliding. Another RBI on the double, and now it's only a four-run lead. Still slam-proof, but not possible. One more hit, possibly not for long. As now they go to the top of the order, and Tolson's going to dig in. I believe Grant Simmons is warming up right now. Takes a rip at this one up the middle. All the way out. Kasternak tries to get on it. Here comes Coleman gliding home. He's in. Tolson gets an RBI after a slow day. Start to his day. And now it's a three-run lead. And here comes pitching coach Mike Mowaka, possibly trying to buy more time for the pen, as this game is not the sure thing as it was. Like I said, this game was looking good for the Foresters, and all of a sudden things have gotten hairy. Baker's still in this one as he throws a first pitch strike in to Langron. He flew out to right his last inning, and that one goes low for a ball. The 1-1 is clips the corner for a strike. Now that Bethel bench is antsy. Game they possibly thought they were out of, all of a sudden looks a lot more favorable all of a sudden, as that one will be just outside for a ball. Baker has thrown 30 pitches here. As I said before, just went 1-2-3 in his first and now facing a hairy situation. This one up the middle. Kursenak flips it one to end the game. It's going to be late. So he gets on the fielder's choice, and now it's Jacob Sitterly digging in. The game on his bat as it's going to go foul. Wolf had to give chase on it. It's a five spot in the ninth here for the Pilots. And here's the 0-1 that goes in the turf. The 1-1 swung on. This one goes towards Deckman, who has to back up on it. Going to go into second. Kasternak there. And now one swing as we go to the top. Right back to where we started. Dessler led off the inning with a walk. And now he's right back up to bat as here comes Coach Frame, who takes the ball from Baker, who went through the order. And we'll step aside here momentarily as we get ready. One more out for the Foresters to give, but one swing can tie it. We'll be right back here on FDN Sports. Anderson Fenton takes the mound, is in his fifth appearance, has yet to give up a run, has five strikeouts, needs one out here, but the catcher Diesler is one swing away from tying this game up. He has one long one on the year. But Fenton gets a first pitch strike. This one towards Wolf at third. Gonna go the long way. This game is over. Fenton needs two pitches to get the save. And game one belongs to the Foresters. We'll be back here for game two. Thanks for joining us. Foresters win game one, 8-5.